So this is a short video to explain in a nutshell what is changing with the new measure algorithm update that Google is rolling out now, the BERT algorithm update. Technically, it is a very complex theme. I will place a link so that anyone wants to read what Google has explained in their AI page. You can see all of the technical specifications because it has to do with artificial intelligence. It is basically a new change that will make sure that the machines can learn better from what we do, which I find extremely fascinating. They can understand the way we as humans use our language, how we use the words, because we don't really research just with keywords, especially when we do voice search, we use words, we use expressions. And Google needs to be able to decode the way we talk. And they say that of billions of searches they are done every day, like 15% of them are new searches that they have not been done before. And they need to be able to predict how we think and how we search, how we want to call things. And they predict that this change will affect one query in 10, especially in the English-based language. But that will especially affect the complex queries, the queries that change according to the words they used before and after. Let me give an example, a couple of examples, the ones that Google gives. They mention, for example, if a Brazilian traveler needs, searching for Brazilian traveler needs a visa to visit USA. In this case, well, before the change in the algorithm, Google would have just extrapolated bits, and you would have seen Brazil travel, USA visa. So you would see that to travel to maybe you might have seen something that was not relevant, which is the reason why Google now is doing the change. They're doing the changes to try and help us more. Try and make sure that we get results. They are always more relevant to what we want, which is their mission, actually. Their mission is to give the user the best, the Google user, Google search user, the best type of user experience, giving the best type of results. So before you may have seen something like USA traveler to Brazil and what you may need if you're a USA traveler. Instead, this update is training the algorithm to understand that in that query, Brazil traveler to USA need a visa, the to USA with that preposition placed before the country, it changes completely the meaning of it in the sentence. So it is unique, and it is exactly what the user is searching for. They want to know to USA what happens, and then they will give results connected with the embassies, Brazilian embassies, if you need something to go, and yes, you need. You will see types of new visas that you need and so on. Another example that they give, and it is very clear then to understand, is for example, if you search for another informative query like, can I buy a medicine for a person in a pharmacy? This Well, before the change, Google would have extrapolated things like biomedicine, person, pharmacy. So you would have probably got like a list of results of pharmacies the closest to you with good localization and these kind of things. But it's not the type of questions that you asked. You wanted to know if an informative answer, if you can buy something for a person. So now Google, with this change, will be able to understand that this for a person changes completely the meaning of the phrase. And then it is unique, the type of answer that you can get. And it is according to the regulations, yes or no, and how you can buy a medicine for somebody else. So it is actually understanding that some prepositions and some words using before and after, they change the meaning in a sentence completely. Now, this is the second change that they have done to the algorithm regarding the way of people search for the expressions. The one they did before was called the hummingbird, and it was in 2013, 6 years ago. And it was already a big change because it did not just give importance to the words they used on the page, but also on the other words. So not just the keyword, but even the context. And that is why now we give so much importance to the related keywords. We don't really talk about keywords, but to entities, semantic entities, this meaning on the page, which needs to be reinforced, making sure that Google really understands what the page is about by using all of the possible related terms, which basically make up all together this entity meaning. And this was an attempt to try and make pages more relevant, to give more relevant results, to fight manipulation. And once again, all of those changes in the job for nearly 10 years, I've seen all the major ones, the ones they were called with the animal names like the panda, the penguin, they were so disruptive at the time. And all these changes, they are meant to help the user and to give best possible results. So as web owners, website owners, what we need to do, and as SEO specialists, what we need to advise is to try and always have the search intent at the back of your mind. So always think of what is the user looking for. What do they want? What do they need? And how can I best serve their needs with my content? How can I make sure that my content is the best possible solution for them? And first of all, you need to research. You need to know what they want, and then you need to be able to think of giving the best experience without trying to manipulate. And in this way, we are safe from any kind of change. I hope this was helpful. Let me know if you have any questions, and thank you for staying here.